All the iconic designs like the iPod, TVs, brand logos, and famous paintings have one thing in common. They're all inspired by something called the golden ratio. It's a mysterious number found in nature and mathematics that has been shaping art and design for centuries. From ancient Roman architecture to modern products, this ratio is said to create balance and beauty. But why is it so special? In today's video, we'll dive into how the golden ratio shapes the physical and digital products you love, and whether it's truly the key to perfection or just a design myth. And we'll start with something called the golden spiral. Let's see how you can make it, both growing inwards and outwards. To make an inward growing golden spiral, we need to understand golden rectangle first. And to understand golden rectangle, we need to understand the golden ratio first. Let's take a line segment AB and divide it into two unequal parts AC and BC. If the longer part AC divided by the smaller part BC equals to the whole line AB divided by the larger part AC, and both of them equals to 1.618, then we'll say that the line is divided in the golden ratio. And similarly, a golden rectangle is created when the ratio of its longer side to its shorter sides equal the golden ratio, that is again the number 1.618. Now, to create a golden spiral, you remove a square from the golden rectangle with the side equal to the smaller side, and the remaining smaller rectangle will also be a golden rectangle. This property allows for recursive pattern and spirals. By repeatedly removing squares from golden rectangles and connecting points with a curve, you can create the golden spiral that is moving inwards. But to create a golden spiral that is moving outwards, we need to understand a special series of numbers which are called the Fibonacci series. It is a sequence of numbers where each number is the sum of two preceding numbers, starting from 0 and 1. It goes like this: 0 and 1, which on adding results in 1. Then adding 1 and 1 gives us 2. And then it continues as 3, 5, 8, 13, 21, and so on. What's fascinating about this sequence is that as the numbers increase, the ratio between consecutive numbers approaches to 1.618, the golden ratio. For example, dividing 8 by 5 gives us 1.6, and dividing 21 by 13 gives us approximately 1.615. And as we go further in the series, the ratio gets even closer to 1.618. To create a golden spiral using the Fibonacci series, you start with squares whose side lengths match Fibonacci numbers. For instance, begin with the square of side 1. Then add another square of side 1 next to it. Add a square of side 2 on top, followed by a square of side 3, and so on. Connect the corners of these squares with a smooth quarter circle arc, and you will see an outward growing spiral emerge out of it. Okay, so now we know how to make these spirals both inwards and outwards. But how does this golden spirals and golden rectangles help us to design things in a better way? For centuries, it has been integral to architecture and art. Ancient Greek architects are believed to have used the golden ratio in the Parthenon, designing its facade and column spacing to reflect these proportions, which they associated with perfection. During the Renaissance period, artists and architects like Leonardo da Vinci and Michelangelo embraced the golden ratio to enhance the visual harmony of their works. Da Vinci's Virtuous Man and The Last Supper are said to incorporate golden rectangles and spirals to guide composition and proportions. In Gothic cathedrals, including Notre Dame, golden rectangles helped organize structural elements like the windows and doorways, creating visually balanced design. But this channel is about the science of products. So let's see how this ratio can affect them. For the design of physical products, it can be used in three ways. First, for dimensions. Second, for proportions. And third, for overall form and shape. For the dimensions, it's mostly applicable for products that are kind of rectangle in shape. Smartphones, screens, laptops, doors, windows, or any kind of boxy shape. Like if you see all the 16:9 or 16:10 aspect ratio in screens, it seems very natural and comforting. because it's closer to the golden ratio. Even here, when you're watching this video on YouTube, it has the aspect ratio of 16:9. And sometimes, when you see some music or cinematic videos with longer width, it seems very weird. And same goes for the overall dimensions of any product. Like this original iPod, which has the dimensions of 4.02 inches by 2.43 inches, which again comes down close to 1.618. But as time passed, the needs of the products changes, and now we want more screen sizes, so the original ratio is not valid anymore. And that's fine too, because it's not just the screens. Look for any product or part of a product where you need to have a balanced rectangle. You can use the golden rectangle proportions. Like here, on the touchpad of my laptop, it's again in the golden proportions. Talking about the proportion, it's not just the dimension that are important. Correctly defining proportions is also very crucial. In any product, there can be different elements, and it is very important to balance them aesthetically by giving them proper proportions and spacing. Like how much should be the screen to body ratio in any device? What should be the seat height to the total chair height? Or how to divide a door in the bottom and upper part? All such decisions can also be based on the golden ratio of the line segments, where you can define the longer and shorter proportion such that its ratio is closer to 1.618. But of course, it's not always that straightforward and rigid. And that's why I found that it doesn't have to be exact 1.618. Even if you keep the ratio in the range of 1.5 to 1.7, the proportions still feel very natural and pleasing. And now, let's talk about the aesthetics. You can use the golden ratio in the form of golden spiral to design forms that are both natural and ergonomic. Let's take automotive design for example. In the cars, the flowing lines and the contours are often inspired by spirals, creating shapes that feel balanced and elegant while serving functional purposes like aerodynamics. Luxury cars like Ferraris and Porsches often use smooth, continuous curve to evoke motion and harmony. These curves are not just aesthetically pleasing, they help in optimizing airflow, reduce drag, and create a sense of dynamic balance. Similarly, the edges and fillets on a car panels can be designed with the proportions close to the golden ratio, balancing sharpness and smoothness. Too sharp and a car might feel overly aggressive, too soft and it could lack character. The golden ratio provides a middle ground that feels intuitive to the human eye. For smaller consumer products like appliances and tools, golden spirals can guide shapes that look organic and are comfortable to hold. Whether it's a kettle, a mouse, or a shaver, designing curves inspired by natural pattern ensures products that are not only visually engaging, but also ergonomic. And even if you want to go deep in your design process, and just talk about a simple curve like a fillet, if you use the golden proportion, it instantly becomes much more natural. Like here is a simple square with side of 500 mm. If you apply a regular fillet of 100 mm each, that's how it will look like. Now, let's take a golden rectangle and trim the four sides and apply the tangent fillet again. See how the whole shape becomes much more natural. Let's move up a notch and choose a bigger golden rectangle and again apply tangent fillet. See how the square with the golden fillets feel much more natural and free-flowing. So that's how you can use the golden proportion starting from basic 2D shapes to all the way to 3D curves. And talking about the 2D, now let's move to how golden ratio can be helpful in layout designing. Again, I'll start with a simple example. Let's say we have to make a simple layout for a page in a magazine. So we'll just take an A4 page and put the golden spiral as our base layer. Now, as we know that the center of spiral is a focus point, so I'll choose this area for our title or our heading. And as we move outwards, in the next box, I'll put the subheading. Then the next focus point will be this box. So I'll put my description there. And for the largest box, I'll insert a photo to finish the page. And that's how, without much effort, we can create a simple layout with a golden spiral. And that's just one example. You can use this for your presentation, web page designs, app UIs, basically in any scenario where you want the reader to focus first on one thing then on another in a certain moving pattern. Then the next use case of the golden ratio can be in logo design. It's not something that I made, but there are a few iconic logos which are the ideal case studies for the use of the golden spiral. Now, they don't use the golden spiral curves directly like we used in the 2D shapes. But here, we make circles in each square of the golden spiral and then use those circles to create arcs of a logo. First is the Apple logo with a bite cut off on the right side. It is made up from arcs which are derived from the different circles of the golden spiral. Same goes for the Twitter logo, where all the feathers, body, and the head of the bird is made from different arcs. Pepsi's logo is another example, where it not only uses similar circles, but the diameter of two circles are also in the ratio of 1.618. And that's one way how iconic logos can be designed with this divine ratio that will grab your attention and will make your focus instantly. But one more category of products where focus is the key are photos. In any photo, usually there's a subject where the viewer's focus is supposed to go in the first second. By overlaying a golden spiral on a frame, you can position the subject or the focal point in the center of the spiral, ensuring it captures attention immediately. As the eye moves outwards along the spiral, supporting elements of the image can be arranged to create a visual journey and to tell the story of the photograph. However, practically using the golden spiral during a photo shoot can be challenging because it's not user-friendly to visualize such a complex shape on the viewport or the camera screen. That's why the rule of thirds is often preferred. It provides a simple, grid-based approximation of balance and focus that's easier to overlay and follow in real time. Then, in post-production, photographers can return to the golden spiral to fine-tune their compositions and output a better and balanced photo. To wrap things up, the golden ratio isn't just a number. It's a bridge between nature, mathematics, and human psychology. It resonates with us because it feels balanced, organic, and pleasing to the eye. But remember, design is about solving problems. And while the golden ratio can be a great tool, it's not the only way to create harmony. Rules are meant to bend, and sometimes breaking them leads to even more exciting results. For example, the initial version of the iPod followed the ratio, but then we made iPods with bigger screens and even no screens. So it can be a starting point, but the design of a product will always follow its own journey, catering to user needs and preferences. How will you use the golden ratio in your next design project? Let me know in the comments below. If you found this video helpful, please give it a like and subscribe for more deep dives into the science of design. That's all for today. I'll see you next time. Thank you.